Okay, again, we're looking for the derivative, and this time we have ln of x divided by x squared. So the division sign tells me that we have a quotient rule. So that's because of the division sign right there. So now that we know it's the quotient rule, we're gonna go ahead and do the 1, the 2, the 1 prime, 2 prime as usual, and figure out what each one piece is gonna be and multiply and divide and so on. So the top is ln of x, so that's gonna be my first. The bottom is x squared, so that's gonna be my second. The derivative of ln of x is going to be as usual. We can write the argument down on the denominator. That's going to be an x. And then the numerator is going to be the derivative of x, which is 1. And same again with the x squared. The derivative is going to be with the power rule. With the power rule is going to be 2x. All right, so now that we have done this, we're going to multiply the 1, 2, and then the 2 prime 1, and put a minus in the middle. Okay, so the quotient rule is gonna say dy over dx, that's the derivative, equals to, it's a massive fraction where we multiply the 1 prime 2 together. So 1 prime is 1 over x times 2, which is x squared. Then minus, that's the same minus that was in the middle. We're gonna put it in the middle. And then the 2 prime 1. So that's 2x times the ln of x. All divided by the old denominator, square. So the old denominator used to be x squared. We're gonna take that guy and square it one more time. So that's technically the answer, except it looks pretty terrible. Let's clean it up a little bit. So I'm gonna go dy over dx and 1 over x times x squared. Together, that's just gonna be x minus 2x ln of x, all divided by x squared is gonna be x to the power of 4. So a couple of things I did here, 1 over x times x squared, that's the same thing as x squared over 1, so that's pretty much x squared over x, which simplifies back to x. The other thing I did was x squared, I said that is gonna be x to the power of 4, because when bases raise to a power and raise to a power again, you're expected to multiply the powers. Okay, so now that everything is finished, we'll take a look at the numerator here. And if you notice that there's a term with an x, there's a term with 2x ln of x. So the x is kind of repeating. This x right here is repeating again there. So what I'm going to do now is pretty much factor the x out. And I'm going to do that to clean up the little derivative answer. So it's going to be something like x on the outside. So that's the x that I'm taking out from both terms. I'm factoring it out. This is the GCF method. That leaves me with 1 minus 2 ln of x, all divided by x to the power of 4. And this gives me, so finally, this will give me, when I simplify it and reduce it to lowest terms, it will tell me that the derivative with respect to x is 1 minus 2 ln of x divided by x to the power of 3. Okay, remember there were 4 x's and we can cancel one and the other one. So I'm canceling this x with the x down here, and that's gonna give me the reduced version of the answer. And that's basically how it's gonna end.